Samuel, you?
I'm going to go with the stats on this one and say that Forrest will be the MVP.
All right,
but
then.
It looks like we're loading into our first map of this grand final here. Best of three, 30 grand on the line, and it's going to be Na'Vi versus Ninjas in Pajamas.
Yes, it is a pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Na'Vi versus NIP. This is going to be a best of three game, and obviously between two of the best teams in the world, it seems, right now.
At this event, anyways.
Ah, well, maybe we're about to find out if Na'Vi can actually replicate that victory they had at SLTV Star Series. There it is, the opening kill of the Grand Finals. Forrest gonna take down Guardian, definitely a good kill, but Edward immediately returning and a really strong pistol player. So is Forrest though, so it's hard to say exactly how this is gonna turn out. Freiburg goes down after getting a kill himself, and now it's a 3-on-3 with Seuss dropping pretty low. And it's just an aim duel in the middle. Get right, charging out of Boiler Room. He's gonna go down, somehow seized, survives. He even makes it around the corner, and now they're gonna charge in towards the bomb site, taking another fight here, and it's gonna be all Forrest. 1-on-3. He hasn't got the bomb, he's gonna have to try and go and pick it up. He's missing a lot of shots, and that just might get him killed. 5 HP in a 1-on-3 up in the apartments here.
Yeah, good start for Na'Vi here. I mean, couldn't really be better. Forrest with 5 health, almost no chance for him to really come back and win this round for his team.
And not easy, is it?
Yeah.
Is there really anything he can actually do at this point?
Sure. Both Seized and Zeus are very low, so, I mean, if he gets aim duels one at a time, sure, there's something. But, I mean, if Na'Vi are smart, they don't challenge him. They just keep hiding and just attack him together, and in that scenario, Forrest has no chance.
Yeah, it looked like Seuss for a second was thinking about taking that aim duel, but he thought the better of it, and Starix helps him out, and it's Na'Vi winning the first round here. On the CT side as well, has to be considered a pretty strong start. So let's see if it's going to continue that way, and if NIP are actually going to buy any armor and the infamous C-set 75s on the second round.
We'll see. I think NIP is going to go for the buy. They've been doing it all tournament long. I don't see it changing now.
No, and you are right. They will. But actually, look at this. Even Molotovs and a lot of smokes and grenades here, so they are ready to fight Na'Vi. Pretty aggressive move already. Edward being here in the middle, just shooting down, trying to see if he can maybe catch an early kill on somebody. And NIP all moving up towards Banana, trying to see if they can get into that B bomb site. With all the smokes they have and the Molotovs, a pretty good bet that might actually be a possibility here. As Na'Vi smartly smoking off NIP. This is going to be really hard for them, I think, to get in against, you know, the weapons on the other side.
We'll see. It's going to be a B attack, like you said. And oh, just at the right time, Starix gets blinded. This could be dangerous if NIP gets set up in the site.
Might very well, at the very least, be a bomb plant here. Smokes are actually working. They almost killed the bomb plant, but the bomb does go down, and now it's a full 5-on-5 retake here. Already a pretty good success here for NIP. Now they just need to hold on to it, and there's only one kit on Seuss, so if he dies in the wrong spot, that could actually have an impact on this round. But we'll see. Na'Vi still trying to conjure up some sort of retake here. Forrest gets a kill, Edward gets the return, and now the fight is on. They're going to try and run in, jumping down into yellow seas. Starix trying to clear the back of the site, and it's actually going to be a 3-on-3 now. They're stacked up in the corner. Starix running in, and he gets them both down, and everybody from NIP dies, but the time has run out. Na'Vi are on the run, and NIP, they're going to get the second round.
Easy skins, easy life.
Exactly. Oh, that was an... I mean, it seemed to you like they took a long time getting into that bomb site?
Yeah, I mean, they did. And I mean, it's a bummer we can't hear the in-game sounds, so we never actually know how much time there is left on a bomb. So it's hard to know how close they were. I believe they had a kit, right?
They had one on Seuss, and I'm not sure they ever really got him into position either. Oh, there's the in-game sound. And it's even going to be turned up a little bit, so now we have a chance. Maybe a little bit too loud in-game sound. Just turn down a little bit. There we go. All right, we're into the third round, and Na'Vi, in spite of losing that round, they actually go for buying up anyway. Do you agree with this kind of buy?
Yeah, they saved 3 weapons, right? So
yeah, they did. Oh, you're right. They just buy up armor on the pistols and the rest. You're absolutely right. Yeah, flashbangs and a Molotov as well on C is pretty safe there.
And NIP, by the way, has a really insane record in this tournament in both pistol rounds, and then if they lose the pistol, then the second round. Like, they must have, like, an insane record if you just combine those two. Like, how many times NIP has won? If not the pistol, then at least the second round.
They already get the kill on Seuss, and there's Getright taking down Guardian. Now a 5-on-3. And looking pretty damn good for the DreamHack Summer Defending Champions. They did win last year as well. Forrest takes down Seized and up in the apartments. Getright finally goes down to Edward. It might be a little bit too late for that. Now 2-on-4, and they're rushing towards that A bomb site where there's really nobody defending it right now.
Yeah, it's gonna be another round for NIP.
NaVi, if they're lucky, they get to save the one. It looks like they're going to save the one rifle, but that's pretty much it. So, I don't know. If we bring up the scoreboard, what's the economy like for NaVi right now? It's not looking very good. So, it's going to be an eco for them, no doubt.
That it is. We'll see if NaVi are actually able to save these guns, because NIP are, well, running away. Yeah, they are going to be able to save these guns.
Yeah.
Though Starix only has a CZ-75. Edward has an M4A1 and an armor, so...
Now, I'm not saying that it's very likely it'll ever happen, but because he has armor and the one kit, I sort of wish Starix would just go for, like, a ninja defuse. Like, they'd boost him up inside the bomb set and try and make it work, just because it's... The only time that's even remotely happened was that one time when Dupree actually did the ninja defuse on Nuke in during the frag fight.
You know the problem with ninja defuses in CSGO? It's that the bomb radius... It's just so random. Like,
yeah.
There's so many places you can be in big pit looking at the bomb explode,
yeah,
and not explode. So, I mean, that's just a problem.
Yeah, people don't have much of an incentive to run far,
yeah,
away. Yeah, that might be a problem. Did they pick up a rifle at the end? I think Starix must have saved the rifle,
yeah,
right at the end. So
that's
a big change.
Like.
I'm going to go and try and peek in here. Freiburg gets overrun. CZ-75 once again in action. Seuss picks up the first kill.
Nice, nicely timed peek there by NaVi with two people running out at the same time. Freiburg never had a chance there, despite having a better gun.
Yeah. Double team him. That's the plan. That actually forces NIP, well, you know, they sort of walk up the middle and they run into a few smokes, and now they're going to go back towards Banana. They spot a person and get spotted themselves. So now, NaVi have some decent information about what's going on right now.
That they do. NIPR, though, moving up here. NaVi in the rotation, actually. Look at that. NaVi is going to have four people in the B bomb site if NIP delays just a tiny bit more. This could be really dangerous for the Swedes.
They're essentially walking into a death trap, and there's not that much time left either. Just 30 seconds on the clock, so they need to make up their minds right now, and they have made up their minds. They're going to go for the B bomb site. Seize is ready with an AK in the Guardian hiding there. Seize gets the one. He's going to try and fall back. They get overrun him. That's very nicely done. Forrest and Care Right with the kills. We're flaring, looking for one more, trying to see if he can take down Seuss, who's actually going to run away. So 3-on-3, but it should be NIP having the advantage here.
Yeah, NaVi actually started second-guessing themselves. They were already on the rotation to B, and then two of their players started going back to A, so... Had they just full gone for it, they might have had a chance there. Or if Seize just got one more kill.
Now NaVi just gunning from a distance, looking to get the kills, but they're not really committing to this retake, and I can't really blame them for it.
No, they should be saving these weapons, or just trying to get some exit kills, as Starix is doing here. But Seize can't connect.
Oh, Geraint landing some good headshots, though. Edward will return, should get a second one, but actually takes a little bit too long. Geraint, he might still die to the bomb if he's not fast at running away. And Farron, oh yes, Geraint dying. Farron, look how close he's hiding. That's,
yeah,
what we're just talking about. Riding construction.
I wonder if Edward got the kill on Farron or vice versa there at the end. We heard some gunfire, but not really sure what happened.
Yeah. No kill happening at the end. All right. So far, it is a pretty good start to the game here for NIP, who previously in the tournament said they've been not feeling too confident in Inferno. So to get a good start like this has to mean a lot to them. That sort of supports the 2-0 idea we've been talking about.
Yeah.
AKs all around for NIP. Seized is going to pick up the opening kill. He gets down those Starix with the immediate return. So pretty nice teamwork. But then there's Forrest. It's just a back and forth all across the map. They're dueling it out here. And it's pretty much uncoordinated. But now there's finally some teamwork coming in here for NIP. Jumping down into the pit. They're going to go for the A bomb site. And there's only a single person defending. And he's actually smartly walking up into the apartments. And this is Edward. This could be a strong play from Edward.
It could, but we'll see. I mean, it's a tough spot to get out. A nice shot on Forrest. Still, two NIP players in good spots here, especially Get Right. The best closer in the game. See what happens.
Baron waiting here, smartly done. Going to take down Starix. Now goes for the second. Takes down Edward now. A one-on-one versus Seuss. And actually, the bomb is planted not in a good position for Fifaron here. He's going to have to try and run in. Seuss isn't faking it. He's going for it. Fifaron has to move. Seuss is in the corner. The bomb is defused. He kills Fifaron as well. And that is some bravery on Seuss's part there. Nicely done.
Yeah, this is good job by Seuss there. I mean... Bit of a mistake by Fifaron. There might have been a miscommunication, but wasn't he the one who planted the bomb? Because Get Right was actually in the big pit, and Fifaron was in the site, so that actually makes it a bit of a bigger mistake on his part. Nice kills here, but he really couldn't allow himself, or shouldn't have allowed himself to go as far back as the boiler room.
I'm wondering if they planted like that because they felt pressured initially, because they actually had the bomb sign when they put the bomb down, so they would have had time to do the normal plant. Maybe a little bit of a misplay from NIP then.
Yeah. Well, there you have it. You get the best way. Get right, taking on a lot of damage. Goes down in the hands of Zuzus, gets a second kill there in the middle.
Oh, wow.
Inward gets a kill. All of a sudden, it looks like he might get a tight score. Hey, Guardian just saves his teammate in lane.
That's a very good timing here from NaVi, and they're really good at just trading kills. Even one dies, there's another one to pick it up, and Seized will pick up the final kill. So they are going to tide, you're right. It's 3-3 moving into the seventh round and looking really good.
Yeah, I was about to say, I mean, the only round that that NIP won that gave in those two ecos was actually the one where they actually all got taken out, but NaVi just couldn't get to the defuse on time.
Oh, you're right.
So, like, conceivably, this could be 6-0 for NaVi even.
Yeah, that's a good point to make, especially if we just think about how the rest of this half is gonna unfold. Because obviously, if it finishes 12-3, that's not gonna be enough for NIP, no doubt about that. And Seized opening up, though, it's an eco round from NIP, still good to get that early kill.
Edward playing very aggressive in middle.
All right. I mean, and NaVi aren't playing at all like they're scared of NIP. I mean, can we say that much at least? And that's probably a really good sign for them.
Well, I mean, we already knew they weren't going to be, because they were going to be one of those teams. It's just the CIS teams. They just have that mentality. They're not scared of anybody.
Don't forget.
And unlike a lot of other teams, they actually mean it too. Edward takes on a lot of damage. He's not going to be able to get that kill. And this could be dangerous for NaVi now.
Seuss goes down. Form is going to be planted. Almost a 3-on-3 as France on 4 HP. Forest is going to go down. And now it is looking very dangerous. AWP on Guardian. And I'm not sure if they can actually retake this bomb site that easily. There's no grenades on NIP, but we've found picking up yet a kill here. It's going to be down to a 2-on-3. Starry's left and Seas is left. And they're really trying for it, but they're running out of time. Even with the kits, they've got to make a move pretty soon. There's one dead, and Get Right controls the spray, takes down Starix, and wins the round for NIP. So that was a bit of a throwaway from NaVi.
Yeah, they played over-aggressive there in lane, and I actually have no idea how Zeus died. He was the key member in that round. I have no idea how he got taken out by a Glock by Get Right. So,
no.
Big mistake on Navi's part there.
Gonna move us into the eighth round. Fiflaren has actually picked up and saved the AWP, so he's really serious about this, and they did this earlier as well. So maybe he's feeling confident right now. Good grenade. Actually, no, that wasn't a good grenade. I was gonna say, it looked like it landed right on top of him, but not quite enough.
No, and Edward has pushed aggressively in the apartment. Can't connect, falls back far. Fiflaren actually has kept the op, by the way, from the previous round, so it's an interesting choice.
It makes me wonder, you know, Edward, he spotted one, fell back. I'm wondering if Angel had been there, if he would have fallen back, or if he would have probably just peeked another 7 times until he either died or got the kill.
No, I think Angel peeks until he dies. And if there's no one there, he pushes forward until he gets to peek. That's how he's programmed to do.
It's actually pretty impressive because he must feel confident in it. We'll have to get some stats to see how often that actually works. Flash on over. Are they going to peek behind the flash? They're certainly ready for it. But actually, they just set up here, so just a bit of a tester maybe. Time now. Still about 30-some seconds left on the clock, and NIP are going to have to make a move into the B bomb site. And now, well, the game is on. They're ready for it. Freiburg leading the charge. He gets actually team flashed, I think, and he can't see a thing. Forest and Exist, though, they pick up the kills, and NaVi, they lose the bomb site, and now this retake is going to be very tough.
It's going to be next to impossible without something crazy happening. Guardian deals a lot of damage there through the smoke, but can get a kill. Edward and Zeus are actually already saving their weapons, so it's going to be another round for NIP.
This seems like one of those rounds that is really, really hard to account for, where, you know, obviously, NaVi, they had a pretty good setup. They had the smoke up. Everything seems to be running pretty well. Was it just a flashbang that settled that round?
I think so. And just, you know, sometimes you just hit that shot. So sometimes the terrorist going in gets a kill that you maybe shouldn't have gotten. That happened a lot with Guardian in the, what was it, the semifinal?
Yeah.
Is it able to get a lot of no, actually the quarterfinal against Virtus Pro, he's able to get a lot of entry kills going into B on Inferno, so sometimes you just have it easy.
Well,
easy skins, easy life.
Easy skins indeed.
That's the best poster ever for
that
a Counter-Strike
the
tournament. There's never been a better one.
Big shout out to the guy in the audience who managed to get that poster in. We should get more shots of that. Very nicely done, so. Well, we're moving into the ninth round and still looking, I mean, pretty good for NIP considering, considering their early performances. And now they've got to be careful. If they lose these guns, they probably won't have anything.
Yeah, I mean, when we look at the scoreboard, it's actually been Guardian now who's been dropping the ball a little bit. I mean, he wasn't able to get a kill on that eco round that they lost. He wasn't able to get a kill on the second round, I think. Yeah. And, you know, he really hasn't been the Guardian we grew accustomed to after the first Flipside game. And if Guardian plays like he did in the Flipside loss, then NaVi are not going to be winning the series. There's no chance. So he's going to have to step up a little bit.
He has, luckily, a best of three to try and do it in, but obviously you don't want to throw away the first map that you were pretty hoping to win.
Yeah.
So
I mean, of course, the M4 is not his strongest suit, so he needs to get on that op, and he's a better AK player than he's a Cole player, so I mean, there's still some hope there.
Flashbang once again from NaVi inside the bombsite, and he's just really patient here. He's just waiting for NaVi to come and peek, and it's a pretty dangerous game to play because the clock is running down, so if NaVi have more smokes, but they actually don't, so why
does NaVi
have
three people already rotated into B?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Freiburg again, flashed, I think, by his own team, but Guardian will take him down. He dies immediately afterwards. Exist spraying through, but it will be Fufarin picking up that kill, and another really great entrance to the bombsite. Fufarin picks up an orb, he goes for one shot, C75 is out, and that will be enough to take down Zeus. Edward and C's the left, and they're finally going to pick up a kill. It's not too late for NaVi to actually come back and retake this bombsite, but they got to move quickly. They don't have a kit picked up, so it's now or never. They got to commit or fall back.
I think they gotta fall back at this point. I mean, there's just no time left.
Yeah.
And they finally realize it too. They start running away. And it looks like they are gonna be able to save these weapons too. So, I mean, these last two rounds now, NaVi have actually had three people at B, I think, by the time NIP actually hits the bomb site. I think it also almost happened on that save round. But the problem is, they usually always tend to have one player stuck in construction, just completely unable to help. And by the time he gets to the bombsite side of it, NIP has already smoked that off, so he's completely useless. Now, basically what they're not doing is how they were playing earlier on against Virtus Pro, where Starix would always be peeking the CT spawn side, and he would just always be waiting behind the smoke and getting those kills as NIP's entering the site. Because once they're into that site, you just can't stop him, it seems.
Well, it also feels like NaVi have had a lot of rounds so far where they've been actually just saving a lot of rifles. Is that a sign that they're actually just not committing enough to these retakes and falling back too quickly?
No, it's a sign of them not having enough gear to win those retakes, and it's being in unfavorable spots. I mean, the times they've saved, there really was no chance they were going to win those rounds, so they really needed to save. It would have been a different story if they went for a save in that 2v3 in the A site on that save round loss.
All right, then. But once again, NaVi with a buy where they actually can't equip the Guardian with an AWP. We'll see if that's going to be a problem. Seized with a good opening kill. Takes down Forest, and that's exactly the sort of stuff that NaVi need right now, because they actually have to bring it back and start winning a lot of rounds in a row here.
Yeah. And Exist down to very low health, just 10 health points left on him. But get right, nice kill on Edward there.
Zeus with a good return, but it is still a pretty good kill. Guardian in the corner here has to try and see if he can find a shot. He will take down Fufarin. That's a 2-on-4 here, exist very low. It looks like a NaVi round.
Yeah, but if Freiburg can get a couple entries, this round can turn around very quickly. I mean, we saw what Freiburg did on the deciding round against Hellraiser, so it's all on him now for this one.
In the back of side, actually, there's one guy hiding, so they got to get rid of him first. They have the smoke to cover up so they can safely cross. Freiburg checking absolutely everywhere and looking the wrong way right now. Starix gets the one kill, so now it's all on Freiburg, and he's going to go down. Well played, Starix, defending against that. Also just preventing NIP from even putting the bomb down.
An important round win for NaVi in the sense also that only one of their players died, and that's going to be helpful for their economy. I mean, even that buy round for NaVi wasn't a proper buy round. They constantly keep saving, so all their buys are sort of a desperation buys in a way.
Quick smoke there to the bottom of Banana, trying to prevent NIP from taking control, and now they're going to push behind it. They have a Molotov as well, but NIP throwing another one, so it's a complete bombardment here at Banana from both sides. Freiburg shooting while flashed, can't see a thing. More grenades, they actually do good damage to NIP, but now Freiburg ready to be unleashed. He's gonna go down though. Exist will get the kill on Starix, and Seized picks up another one, so it's NaVi coming out of that pretty chaotic battle over on Banana.
And it's actually surprising NaVi took this long to play aggressive in Banana, because that's what they were doing earlier quite a bit.
You're right.
So that's probably an adjustment, because they probably know that NIP was watching their demos, and Freiburg obviously pointed that out as well. So they did not want to do something that NIP would be able to counter early on. Now they realize their B defense is not working, and they went for the push, and it seems to pay off.
Yeah, And if they, I think if NaVi can finish up 9-6 here, they're going to be really happy. But many more rounds in favor of NIP, that's going to be a big problem for the CIS team. Get right, jumps in pit, going to get the one kill. Guardian running out of bullets, he's going to go down. Sush will pick up a kill, but this is a 2-on-2 now. And actually, NaVi have the health advantage and no bomb plant, so they have time to rotate into pretty good positions. NIP, they're locked inside the bomb site, but Sush will get the first kill now. Just one person left, Fiflaren in a 1-on-1. Seize picks out, Fiflaren still alive. He's trying to buy time, trying to run away, and Seize is not committing to it yet. He's got no more grenades, just the M4. He's looking for Fiflaren, and now he knows exactly where he is. That grenade won't do anything except reveal his position. And Seized patiently waiting, but that clock's working against him. Fiflaren trying to juke. Seized running up now. It's going to be close, and he gets the kill, and there is enough time this time to actually get the defuse. So that's a very good win for Seized.
Yeah, that was a very poor grenade by Fiflaren. He really must have thought that Seized was low from somebody else, because that was the only way that nade made any sense.
Yeah.
Because like you said, he just gave up his position, and after that it was easy for Seize to just keep waiting around because there was so much time left on the clock.
There it is. Very nearly happened in that round, but I mean, it is another round that's so close that it obviously digs deep into NaVi's economy, which also means that if they start losing many more rounds, they might eco again, but crucially...
Look at this aggression from Edward.
Oh.
Oh, and he misses!
That's
a crucial mistake by Edward. He really should have been able to get that kill.
Yeah, without even taking any damage, it seemed like.
But look at Get right here. He might be able to get a kill here as he sneaks up.
Did Guardian spot him? I don't think he did. He's walking into certain death and even pre-fired by Get Right. I'm wondering if he saw the shadow or if he just saw him jumping up, but very nicely done.
Poor rotation there. Once again by NaVi, just not understanding NIP could already be there. He's now gotta get a kill. Not gonna happen, and this is gonna be another round for NIP.
Yeah, no doubt about that. I mean, questioning, it seems like NaVi are... No, they're just looking for extra kills, I think. I hope they're not going to commit to this, because that would be another situation where they'd just be throwing away two rifles.
Well, it looks like they are going to throw away one rifle anyways. But Starik should be heading... Yeah, he's going to be heading towards the CT spawn to save his weapon. Kills a chicken on the way.
So, in the B-bomb side, some of the takes NIP have had, we've sort of highlighted that there were some really good flashbangs involved. This time in the pit, I mean, that flashbang lasted for so long that there was actually no chance he could have done anything, that pit player.
Yeah, I mean, once Guardian was taken out and Edward was also taken out, there's weren't enough manpower for NaVi to really win that round. There's no way they were going to defend the A-bomb side with just two players there. Their trouble started with Edward missing that first shot, because that was a kill he should have gotten. Yeah. He would have gotten 9 times out of 10. Missed it this once, and that forced Guardian to stay there way further, and his rotation to apartment was late. And here's Edward just missing that shot, and that's just a terrible mistake.
Yeah, that would have given NIP so much control. They would have been able to check Banana and see that nobody was there, and they would have known where the rest of NIP was. Yeah. So, yeah, that really hurts. And something that NaVi just can't afford at this point. We're 13 rounds into the first half of the first map here, and it's 7-5 in favor of NIP on the less favored side. That has to mean something.
Yeah, though, I guess in T side is probably actually better for NIP. So we don't actually know. In this particular matchup, it may be that both teams will have stronger T sides.
Right now, Starix and Seast are the only two people who have any kind of rifles, and that's a really good peek from Forest. Clean work.
Gets out with 80 health. Fiflaren also getting a kill there.
And then quickly falling back, getting a teammate to repick. So they're rotating people in to make sure that nobody gets too low, maybe. 5-on-3, and I mean, realistically, should they save these last two rifles once again?
It depends on the next kill. I mean, you still want to go for kill because it's only a 3v5. You might be able to get one surprise kill or just surprise two people, spray someone down. I wouldn't save in a 3v5 without NIP committed to a bomb site, but it's getting there. I would have stacked one bomb site, say like everybody in B, and just hope for the best.
Right
now they're too scattered to win this round, I think.
Yep. Get right. We'll pick up another one, and well, that leaves one guy in B. He's going to go down as well. Get right on the hunt. Gets a double. Seized returns a single one, but now they're probably going to be hunting him down. Actually, he picks up a great double here. Another headshot, and that will be the absolute end. Exist will take him down. And I mean, NIP, they're not really too scared of throwing away rifles at this point. They must have some sort of economy going on here to just basically hunt him down.
NIP has tons of money, and you know, the problem for NaVi, I think, so far this half, has been that they keep force buying every single round. Even that round, you saw they have 3 CZ-75s. I think this is like the second round in this half that Guardian is going to have his op, and that just speaks to how little money they've had throughout this first half.
Yeah, not at all a pleasant idea. And actually, you know, just to pick up on that point with Guardians AWP, there's another team that we used to see a lot on Inferno having this kind of issue, or just really any map, which is former Clan Mystic with Kenny S in the lineup. Whenever he would basically run out of money, you'd have a Kenny left that would just maybe not be able to fulfill his role properly. The Get Right opens up nicely with a kill on Edward, and it's going to be once again NIP with the opening kill, and now they just charge in towards Quad, doing a lot of damage to Seuss. He's almost down. Get Right down to the pit. Freiburg going to pick up the one on Seuss, and they have the bomb site. NIP looking to take this 14th round with style.
And NaVi just have no chance here so far. I mean, NIP are just running over their defense currently. It's going to be 9-5, and something's going to change for NaVi to have a chance. I'll say that.
Oh, I mean, I would want to say that they should try and push a little bit more aggressively, because it feels like when they're holding very passively and just covering angles, it seems like someone like Forrest is just able to peek out, take a quick headshot, and that ruins everything. But then the one round where they did push aggressively with Edward, that also didn't work. I mean, what's left in Na'Vi's arsenal here to a try? I mean, it's going to be the 15th round coming up next, so they'll have one more try.
Yep, Guardian able to save that up for the final round. Probably going to be doing something with it. Bit of an unlucky call previous round, so Guardian trying to push towards the car in Banana. Obviously, they got Molotov'd out, just forced to fall back, and then no one came there the whole round. So it must have been a frustrating half for Guardian so far.
Yeah, I would definitely imagine. So bring up the scoreboard real quick. I'm wondering where he's at. Yeah, so 3, 4, and 10, definitely very frustrating. In the middle, immediately dinked down to 2 HP. More frustration coming his way.
Yeah, and I mean, Guardian really should have been more scared. Just played it safer. Like, he really didn't need to jump there. Edward misses a shot. Edward having Get Right with a nice 180 turnaround headshot.
You must be joking. He survives on 3 HP. I mean, I think Edward should have probably picked up that kill either way. But once again, just like down middle, just working for NaVi. NIP, they're making their own luck here. Seized. Oh, that's a great double. Max 7 action coming out on Banana, but still a 3-on-3.
Get Right with very low health, so it's possible NaVi may be able to win this. And that would actually be a big difference if they're able to win this final round, because then winning the pistol round would already tie the game without a last save round. So one round can make a big difference, but it's not looking good despite Get Right's low health.
Definitely not. NaVi don't have a kit, so if the bomb goes down, and it will go down, that means now the clock's heavily in favor of NIP, though. Great kill from Starix. Guardian goes down to a grenade. Fuflaron just has to buy time, wait for a Get Right to get in a good position here. Spots one, does damage, as Get Right, Fuflaron with the headshot, and now it's on Seuss. And obviously there'll be no saving this round, he has to go for it. Fuflaron's already got the two, he's looking for the third one, and right around the corner, he's gonna get the headshot.
And that was just a poor retake from NaVi. I mean, Seuss was just super far away. With the other player charging into the site. So, I mean, that was just poor teamwork there at the end. Great play by NIP, no question about it. I mean, 10-5 to terrorist side half. Though, I actually do think NaVi still have a small chance that we see Fifarian's two headshots there at the end. I do think NaVi are not out of it. If they get the pistol around, there's always a chance to grind out a bunch of rounds on T side. And we've already seen NIP struggle on the CT side of Inferno. They got 4 rounds against Hellraisers. I think they got 5 rounds against SK in the Swedish Championship. So they're not the strongest counter-terrorist team, but they are favored right now to win this first map.
Well, we're about to find out. Already the pistol round is live, and Get Right again with the dual elites. Some grenades here on Navi's side. That's a good shot on Fuflaron. Down to 7 HP, and NIP gonna fall back into the bomb site. They have had enough already of Navi's action in the middle.
Very passive setup for NIP, playing really far back. They don't want to get picked off early on, especially after Fuflaron took on so much damage. And looks like the push is gonna come here on the CT arch side. I think they're gonna go towards spawn.
Assist, man, that was very close to him hitting a headshot right through the smoke. Looked like he was tracing him then. He's in the library or kitchen area now, just waiting, and he's gonna peek right then. Great headshot. Edward goes down. Seuss is gonna take down, but look at this. Get Right, he's hiding in the corner. If they don't check this, it's gonna be devastating.
Looks like they're actually gonna be falling back. So Get Right waited too long. He wasted his opportunity there.
Now Seuss is having a weird angle where nobody's actually hitting much of anything, though he's going to get Seuss to help him out. Freiburg comes in, gets the one, goes for more. He's out of bullets, though. He's going to have to fall back and wait for backup. It's a 2-on-3 still inside the side. There's Freiburg picking up a headshot. Now Guardian has to get this round. He didn't do much in the first half, but this is his chance to basically bring it back for his team. He puts down the bomb. Now a 1-on-2 beam. He guns out, but no! Get Right steals it. Dual elites, they reign supreme. Two pistols are better than one. That's going to be it.
Once again seized, the best player for NaVi by far on Inferno. He's really had a good tournament once more, like he did at SLTV, where he was also considered by many the MVP of the tournament. Edward probably shouldn't have peeked there. And I mean, this is just a really nice shot here from Freiburg after reloading. It's a really nice one tap on the head of Seized. And what can I say? NaVi's just being outgunned.
It really feels like it. And I was about to say earlier that, you know, the one thing that could happen for NiP in the second half that could really sort of mess them up is the same thing that happened to NaVi, is if they run into that ugly spiral where they keep saving a little bit and half buying and everything else like that. But with this kind of style, you know, their economy is going to be much better.
Yeah, it works a lot better on the T side, but this round is key, and that's going to be a very good nade by Exist.
Oh, we're right. Edward down to 54. Not the kind of start that NaVi were looking for. They've actually got a Galil and an AK here already. Picked up pretty early, and some armor as well to support with.
Let's see if Edward can connect here. He's gonna be peaked by Exist any second from Library.
I think he actually just saw the shoulder there, so he's gonna smoke it off so he can focus just on Pit here. Baron with a kill, Exist with another one, and this is working out so well for NiP.
Yeah, NaVi are just having no success with their continuous buys.
No, this is a really one-sided story so far. I mean, it's not been that much that's really been working for NaVi. And this is one of the maps that NIP said they felt the weakest on maybe during this tournament. They felt like they've made some mistakes. Not right now, it seems.
Not right now, no. And Forrest gets a kill here, still stays alive. It's going to be another easy round for NIP. None of their players die. And also something to point out is this is actually NaVi's map pick.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And going off of the rest of the tournament for NIP, we would assume that would have been a pretty solid pick. And then you'd have to play Train, and then you could maybe, you know, decide it on Dust. I can see the thinking going into this from NaVi's point of view. I think maybe they're as surprised as we are that NIP are actually playing this well.
Well, I mean, there were a lot of close rounds in the first half, including the second round that completely changed how the half turned out. Because of NaVi not getting the defuse after killing everybody from NIP, so I think the game has been closer than the score suggests, but at the same time, NIP are still just clearly better so far. I think the problem with NaVi is they're just making wrong decisions in terms of calling, because it's a risky buys that really haven't been working for them. I feel like they would have had more success if they would have just patiently saved and gone for full weapon rounds.
Had more than two or three AWP rounds for Guardian, for instance.
Yeah.
Two or three out of 15, I think one of them was one-way save, so they basically only bought two AWPs, I think, during the first 15 rounds. Fiflaren picks up a good kill there, Starix goes down, but obviously it's an eco round from NaVi, so it's very likely going to be 13-5 here, which feels like too much for NaVi to really bring it back from. Get cleaned up in the middle, and the scoreboard reveals that NIP actually has a really good economy building up already early on in the second half.
They definitely are. I mean, they've had, what, like, zero or one death in these two save rounds.
Now look at that. Almost completely sold out inside the arena. I think actually some of the middle seats up top there are sort of blocked off because the projector is going to get blocked otherwise. So, yeah, some really good turnout here for Counter-Strike. 13-5 is the score. We're into the 19th round, and Seed is going to run into two people. He gets only the one, but Edward's there to pick it up. Freiburg barreling down. Oh, Freiburg picks up a triple. Get right's going to take down Seuss. But that is a pretty mean and devastating round already here. I mean, I think everyone remembers what happened at the end of the Hellraisers game, so Freiburg showing that he's still got it a little bit, and that's going to be the final kill. Forrest with a headshot, and well, NaVi, that was the round they had banked a lot on. They were ready, they had the rifles, but it was nowhere near enough.
No, I mean, that push by NIP just perfectly countered what NaVi were doing, and Freiburg able to get those three kills just completely closed the round before it really even started.
14-5, and it's back to eco for NaVi. It feels like this map is already over. There's an auto sniper on Exist as well. They just have so much firepower on the CT side.
They really do. Exist looking for his second kill here. Gonna get it as well. Probably gonna go for more. Waiting for that head to peek.
Guardian really wants the one deke. If nothing else, he'd like that to have a little bit of a show moment of his own. They're just battling it out in the middle. NIP not really all that worried, and I don't think they should be. Shooting him in the legs takes a little longer, but it's still pretty effective with the auto sniper. And And now, is he going to catch the right angle? He walks right into it, and it will be Richard Landstrom picking up a quad kill here in an anti-eco round. Guardian alone looking for that final deal headshot. He can get it, but he won't get it. Freiburg takes him down, and it's a map point for NIP.
Yeah, NIP just dominant so far in this game. I mean, NaVi had their rounds in the first half, but the second half, they just had nothing going for them since that pistol round, which admittedly was fairly close. And came down to also Freiburg's nice headshots there, so.
Do you think we are going to have maybe a slightly longer break between the two maps here then? Just because Guardian knows that NaVi might actually need a bit of a break to recover from this kind of beating?
I mean, that depends on the tournament admins, doesn't it?
I guess so, if they allow it.
I would assume NaVi don't get to decide, but you know, we'll see what happens.
Old Forest could have got an easy kill there on Guardian. Look very close now. He's just gonna Molotov off towards Boiler Room. Freiburg takes down Guardian, and now 2-on-3. Remember, guys, this is only the first map in the Grand Finals, but the way it's looking right now, NIP, they might be able to hold on to the last DreamHack Summer trophy that they got last year, beating Epsilon then. This time it's not another Swedish team, but they seem to be doing quite well here.
That they are, and they're in a very favorable spot here, 3v2. Starks put this first map away. Edward starts blocking turrets left. Edward gets a kill on Freiburg, makes it a 2v2 now.
Yeah, they got the bomb down eventually. A little bit of a fake there from Starks. Now they're pushing in simultaneously, and that will be it. Forest picks up a double, and NIP, they win Inferno 16-5 against NaVi.
Guardian just invisible. I'm not even sure if he was on the server. But he's put 3-17 in the first map, so I mean, I think he really is, in a way, I mean, he's a character.